Hey, what's up? Welcome back to South 10 Beer Reviews. I am Tyler. Thank you so much for stopping by. Tonight we've got a beer review, and it comes from Burial, and it's in collaboration with Halfway Crooks. Not sure what that is, but before we get into it, just wanted to encourage you to hit that subscribe button if you like what you see. So, collaboration. I don't know what Halfway Crooks is. I don't know if that's a brewery or what. Anyway. Yeah, this is a double IPA. Well, no, it's not. It's a single IPA, 7%. And this is going to be Necessity for Transformation, double IPA. I just said single IPA. What am I doing? Don't know what the date is on this. It's very smudged. If that's even what that was, I don't even know if that was a date, but it's super smudged. It has one of those QR codes on here. And I'm curious to see what it does because I haven't checked. Let's see what it brings up. I'm guessing this is Halfway Crooks, whatever it is. I don't know what's going on. Is that honey? I don't know what this is. That's literally the whole video. Cool. Thanks for that. I don't know what I just watched. Anyway, I'm ready to get into this. We haven't had any Burial beer in a while. If you don't remember, there was a time on my channel where I had went to Burial, came back with like a bunch of beers from them, and reviewed a ton of their beers on the channel. So if you want to, go back and check those out. I love the label on this one though. The color scheme's cool. It's got this eyeball. Actually, there's several eyeballs. But anyway, we're using some proper glassware too. I got this while I was at the brewery. Let's go ahead and crack this thing open. See what we got in store. I do love me some Burial IPAs. Actually, freaking love just Burial in general, but looks familiar. Looks like some of the other Burial beers we tried. All right. I can smell it from here. Killer freaking look. Completely hazy, deep gold color, orange type of hue with it. Looks killer in this proper glassware, not gonna lie. About a finger and a half of bright white head, tight, small bubbles, some medium, some rocky, soapy ones up top. Looks pretty nice. Does this say what it's hopped with or anything? No, 7% though. Anyway, let's go ahead and shove our nose in this thing. Ooh, it's pungent. It's like earthy, herbaceous, tropical. It's like some green earthiness to it. Slight bit of like a I don't know, it's like a spicy herb of some kind. Getting some pithy orange, sweet pineapple. It's like a dank orange or something. Like it's like dank orange juice. That's what this smells like. It's like dank. Like earthy green, herbaceous, dank orange juice. With like some pineapple or something in there, like something a little more tropical. It actually smells really, really tasty. I'm ready to dive in already. Let's go ahead and do it. Cheers. Oh yeah. That's killer. Yeah. Creamy mouthfeel. Medium bodied. But it's soft, super soft, light carbonation. It's got a familiar like burial character to it. So this doesn't mention their what's their they have a like a heavy resin that they do on their beers. This is not heavy resin, but it does have a bit of resin, like a resinous character to it. It's got some pininess there, some like pine resin, if you will. It's earthy though. It's dank. I feel like part of me wants to think there might be mosaic in here. Man. Sweet orange with like a nice pithy, like orange peel zest type of character. A little bit of grapefruit. But man, that citrusy type of quality is awesome. It's dank orange juice. This one is. This is definitely on that scale of things. Like it's dank orange juice. It's got a hint of like some tropical fruit though, like some pineapple, something minimal there. Maybe even a little stone fruit. But this is so good, man. It's like that. It almost has that like West Coast, like sweet orange type of vibe to it, but it's not a West Coast IPA. Like it's very juicy, very minimal on the bitterness. It kind of just hits you with like a pop of like zesty, pithy bitterness, rather than like super piney bitterness. It does have a bit of a piney flavor to it, but it's not coming across in that like overly expressive pine like bitterness, like a West Coast IPA. This is, I mean, I don't know why I'm surprised at this point. Like Burial is just one of those breweries that just they kill it from day in and day out. That is delicious. I wouldn't change anything about this beer. There's something about this brings me back to like my early days of getting into like hazy IPAs for whatever reason. And I feel like it's maybe even making me think of like the first beer I had from them, I think, was Surf Wax IPA, American IPA. And I feel like it has a, I don't remember what that beer tastes like exactly. Even though me and Steven did that beer in a blind review, blind beer from Ridgeopolis. But it almost has that American IPA type of vibe, but it's like scaled back in the bitterness category, but in the juicy hop characteristic is just like bumped way up. This is great, man. I mean, I'm not exaggerating. This is a really tasty beer, especially for just 7%. I mean, you're not picking up any of that alcohol. It's all juicy hops, with a little bit of like earthy, like pine and like some dank quality to it. Dank orange juice. I'm sticking with that. Yeah, there's nothing I would change. I mean, low bitterness, check. Mouthfeel, creamy, soft, check. Huge amounts of like juicy, citrusy hops, check. Dank, check. 7% drinking, great. You're not picking up any alcohol, check. Nice clean finish on it, with a lingering sweetness that, eases its way out as it dries. So, I mean, I wouldn't change anything about it. I think it's fantastic. I'm gonna give this a 4.3. Out of 5, I think it's great. Yeah, that's kind of where I'm at with this one. So, if you've had this, let me know. I would love to hear from you. I have not seen anything about this beer. They've probably posted about it on their Instagram, but I have not seen it. But yeah, fantastic stuff. If you see it, pick it up. Again, this is Necessity for Transformation from Burial out of Asheville, North Carolina. Anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like, comment, subscribe. Do all that fun stuff, and we'll see you in the next review. Cheers.